Welcome to the Bison Coaches Corner. I'm Jeremy Jorgensen, joined by head women's basketball coach Carolyn Diehoff, and we're here to break down Bison women's basketball as they had a road game against South Dakota State, the top team in the conference. And coach, thanks for joining us. And just talk about the week, first of all, because you had an announcement that this was it for you as far as coaching at NDSU. How did the players handle that, and how did that impact your preparation for the game?
Well, certainly, you know, timing isn't always great, and you know, you never really plan on, you know, when it happens or what's going to happen. And so I thought, you know, our players were quite speechless in the locker room when I told them. But I just think sometimes, you know, things are swirling, and you know, I just thought it was best for our players to kind of put some things probably at rest, and did that. And you know, certainly they were emotional, but even following that night, we had practice, and I thought they handled themselves very well. They got after it, executed, you know, drilled what we needed to get done in preparation for South Dakota State on Saturday. So I certainly appreciated the way they handled themselves and came back and had practice that evening.
Now, this game at Brookings was almost a mirror image of the Fargo game, wasn't it? It was a very tight game in the first half. You were right there in position. You had them maybe nervous, if you will, a little bit, and thinking about things, and then it got away from you in the second half, almost exactly like Fargo, wasn't it?
Yeah, you know, I thought we took the crowd out of the game, which is what, you know, you need to do in an environment like that. Certainly talked about that we had played in an environment like that at UND, so we understood, you know, the number of people and then how loud it could get in there. You know, we were down 10 in the first half, did a great job of settling down, and obviously had a nice look from a draw kick to Liz in the corner from Brooke, you know, right before half with a three. You know, had it gone in, you know, a little bit of momentum going up at that point, but certainly, you know, had cut it to two. Came out and tied it at 29 with a three from Holly, and then, you know, just kind of ended up sending them to the free throw line a little more than what we would like, and obviously had some stretches there where we had good execution, a few turnovers that cost us, you know, and couldn't cut back into the lead once they kind of took it, and, you know, it ended up into the 20-point win for South Dakota State.
You know, the final score was, like I said, almost identical, but what do you take out of this game moving forward into the final two games here?
Well, we tweaked a few things offensively that I liked. Our spacing was much better on the floor, and so certainly look to expand a little bit on this week here, you know, with our final two road games at South Dakota and at Denver, and see if we can continue to get better on the offensive end of the floor, because I did like the shots that we got. We did shoot fairly well, and then certainly need to clean up some things defensively in terms of our rotation, see if we can get there quicker and not so late.
And before we set up those final two games, let's talk about Holly Johnson a little bit. She's from Minot, North Dakota. You know, an in-state kid. How has her game progressed? We're going to look at some plays from her this year and just kind of give us your assessment of how her game has developed this season.
Well, she certainly has learned how to play within the system, you know, that we have developed, and certainly her ability to play inside out really complements that system. There she stretches it, you know, by hitting the three. The last one you saw, she got a post catch there by Tay in behind that zone there against Nebraska Omaha. And so she's obviously really excelled offensively for us. The thing that she's really improved on is defensively. You know, she didn't quite understand post play as much last year because, you know, she played a lot of zone in high school where, you know, we're more of a man team, and so she really had to understand how to play the post the way we wanted to play the post, and she's done a good job of that. And so, you know, offensively, defensively, she's just improved as a player that, you know, I really feel comfortable on the floor with.
And like you mentioned, a very tough matchup because she can hit the three. She can also play back to the basket, so, you know, almost a pick-and-pop four player, really, for you, isn't she?
She is, and sometimes, you know, we joke, because I was like, well, you just find yourself inside a little bit more. You know, she likes that big three. You know, that's a big momentum for, you know, most of us. And so I'm just like, if you would just understand, really, the advantage you create by with your back to the basket, too, you know, we need you in there. So, you know, she battles. She's a competitor. She's passionate. She hates to lose. You know, and those things can really bode well for you, and especially for her as a player.
And a player from in-state as well, from Minot, North Dakota. Now, moving forward, South Dakota coming up on Thursday down in Vermilion. They're a tough opponent, and they are trending up, aren't they?
They are. They got IUPUI at home, and certainly, you know, they're trying to position themselves in that third spot. I think there's three teams right now tied, you know, with 6-6, and obviously they have their last two home games here with us in South Dakota State. So the C camp has gotten healthy, so that gives them another, you know, firepower on the with their guard play. She saw a little bit of time here when we played them, so she certainly makes them, you know, better. And then obviously we go to Denver. You know, we had success against Denver here, but again, you know, it's at their place. It's going to be their senior night there. And first time, you know, that we've played there, mm-hmm. at least with this group. We right. played there my first year in a non-conference right. game, a whole different collection of players. But mm-hmm. it's an important weekend for all of us because we're all trying to position ourselves for the tournament the following week.
Denver seemed like a great matchup for you as well. I just felt like, you know, watching that game that, you know, you were a little better than Denver. But it will be tough in their place. And talk about that matchup and what benefits you in that matchup.
Yeah, obviously their post play, you know, I feel we match well with their post play. Again, that versatility that Holly gives us, being able to really post and being able to extend out onto the perimeter. Our guard play, I think, matches really well with them. You know, we have to do a great job on the Van Riper-Rose kid who shoots it very well. I thought we created a little bit of a mismatch, you know, with Brooke. You know, against them, but I'm sure they're going to, you know, have an answer for that because most teams, you know, have done that. So, mm-hmm. You know, we can anticipate that they're going to, you know, lock down her a little bit more. So, you know, we'll just, we got a plan for both. You know, they're going to both challenge us extremely hard. And, you know, we're trying to get ourselves into position to win both of these. If we do that, you know, then mm-hmm. we put ourselves in a position to play on Sunday and not Saturday, I believe.
And also this weekend is about your style of play going into the tournament too. You know, forget about the wins and losses. You want to be playing very good going into that tournament game too, right?
I totally agree. You know, playing your best basketball and, you know, again, watching the film, I thought we did some great things against South Dakota State. Some things that are still kind of hampering us, you know, and that's putting teams to the foul line. So, you know, and teams are going to continue to attack us. We just got to continue to, you know, improve in terms of getting our hands off of, and, you know, we're doing a great job in our conversion defense, in rebounding. I thought we did a great job mm-hmm. against South Dakota State, which are two areas that they're very good at. And we're going to have to do that again with these two teams because they're going to come at us.
Mm-hmm. Thursday night is 104.7 on the radio with Jack Michaels down in Vermillion, and then 740 The Fan on Saturday with Jack. Good luck to you, Coach, and we'll recap these games for you next week.
Thanks, Jeremy.
You betcha. And we'll enjoy some women's basketball next week as well as the Summit League tournament sits on us here, and we'll start to see where things are positioning out and see who plays who down there in Sioux Falls. We'll recap it for you next week here on the Bison Coach's Corner. Have a great week.